Good evening, good morning, all our viewers. Thank you so much for listening to us. So, this is part of the EduShore's College Ghumo series, where we take you around the colleges that you aspire to go to and give you full information on these colleges for you to take a completely informed decision about. For you to take a completely informed decision about where you want to go and what your experience might be at that place. So today we are going to interview two young boys from CDS Kerala, Kuldeep and Preet. And so Kuldeep and Preet, could you just tell us about yourselves? When did you pass out, which year, so that we know which year is it that we are talking about, and which course did you do there?
Let me start first. So hi everyone, my name is Kuldeep Changya. I had joined CDS in their MA in Applied course from 2013 to 2015 batch. So we were the second batch of the MA program that was launched in CDS. So currently I'm working with Novo Nordisk. It's an insulin based pharma firm, and I'm working as an advanced business analyst.
I'm Preet Goenka. So I studied at CDS from 2015 to 2017. And post that, like, I worked for around 3 years, and now I'm pursuing my MBA. So that's something.
All right, lovely. So I'm going to throw questions at both of you. And so first up, the location is Kerala, right? Where is this? How do you get there?
So exactly, it's in Trivandrum. So how do you get there? So basically, there are a lot of modes available. I mean, there is a airport as well and a railway station. So I think people can take,
it's a fairly accessible location.
Yes, definitely. So there are cabs and everywhere. So it's very accessible. So not an issue.
Yep. All right. It's the capital city of Kerala. So yeah.
Right. So it's in the capital of Kerala. Lovely. Okay. Kuldeep, can you take us through what is the affiliation of CDS and which degree did you get finally?
I had also been a student, right? So the most lucrative thing that people see in CDS is the fact that you get the JP. So the affiliation is there. So it's basically, you can say CDS, it's like the southern arm of JNU, if I can say so. Right from its founding members, it has the institute has been regarded very highly in terms of its research capability since its inception. It has produced the alumni are pretty revered across in the economics field. And if you guys go and look into the website, you'll understand through the placement brochures and through the historical information given there as well that the institute is pretty big. And yeah, in terms of the degree that we get is from JNU. So getting that question aside, so it's from JNU. The affiliation is the fact that all our question papers are set. Question papers and everything checking till the batch I was there. I don't know whether it has changed now or not, but during our batch, and I think so with each batch as well, all the questions and everything are set by the faculty in CDS itself. We are graded by the faculty itself, but we also have regular, checkups, as in check-ins from the JNU Institute in terms of, right. But the syllabus as well as, the examination committee, all the administrative measures, everything comes from JNU itself. So all your transcripts and everything you will get from CDS, but your degree, it will be from the Jawaharlal Nehru University.
Okay. So that's like best of both the worlds.
Yes.
Yeah. So in what degree did you pursue? Like JNU has two options, SSS and SIS, two schools which offer MA economics. What is there at CDS?
At CDS, it's actually, there is only one MA course. Again, this is something I'm talking about my experience and a few of my junior batches. But as far as I know, there's only one MA program as of now, which is in applied economics. That's it. There are no other options to an MA.
So this is MA. Please go ahead.
Yeah, so just adding to that, I mean, the course structure that we have at CDS, so that's quite different from what we have at in JNU, which is SSS and SIS. So the concepts that we have in JNU, so basically SSS is general economics and SIS is international economics kind sort of a thing. Yes. But for us, this is applied economics. So whatever we study, so the course structure outline is different. And the so it, and it's more from a application perspective, may it be in the field of impact evaluation or may it be in the field of let's say population studies, or someone who wants to actually see how does economics work in the field of development economics. So that's yes. what makes it different. Yeah.
All right. So that means it's applied economics, and you got opportunities to apply whatever you're studying. So you were involved in research projects. You had to write term papers. How did that translate?
Yes. So we had term papers for almost all the subjects, and apart from that, one of the thing which I think is not there in a lot of institutes, and it's kind of an optional in other in institutes, is for us writing a. So we had a complete paper where we have to put out a dissertation, or we have to write a dissertation under a professor of somewhere around 10,000 words. So it's almost like writing a paper, and like there are very strict checks on plagiarism. So the topic needs to be unique, and I mean the research idea has to be discussed. So you get almost around 5 to 6 months in your last TRISIM to work on this along with the professor. So it kind of gives you a idea that if ever you want to get into, let's say, PhD or MPhil, then how would your life look like? So it's kind of a teaser to that. So that would really help someone to make a decision whether they actually want to get into PhD or higher studies or not.
Lovely. So I think that's a very important part, that if you're writing a dissertation early on, it gives you an edge in trying to decide what your field is, where you want to go, you know, so that really gives you a heads up. That's great. So so how many students does CDS intake?
So during our time, we had like around 20 students. So in our batch, but I think recently they have increased the intake to somewhere around 27 or 28. I'm not exactly sure, but yeah, it's pretty less. So that is one of the benefit I can say, because you kind of get to know your teachers very well. Your teachers understand which students performs, how are they performing, and so the teacher-student ratio is very good. So that way, the learning opportunity is great, because like you can ask your doubts. It's almost kind of a remedial session where you kind of understand how what your teacher is saying. So I think yeah, the lesser batch size is very
all
helpful.
Lovely. So it's a small batch and with personal attention of teachers. It's almost like ISI in that sense. Okay, so that's good. So we have, so this is also a 2-year MA in Applied Economics program.
Right, it's 2 years MA Applied Economics.
Lovely. And so just some basic questions in your medium of instruction is completely English, right?
Yes, it's complete English.
Complete English. All yes. right. Okay. And what was the fees in your time?
So the fees is it's pretty affordable. So basically, if I talk about let's say the academic fees, so it was somewhere around 8,000 per semester, and the hostel fees is around 250 rupees per month. So I mean, if they would have increased it to 300-350, I'm not sure, but at our time it was around 200-250 per month, and for mess you pay somewhere around 2,000-2,500 per month. So overall, I mean, like your course would be done in less than like what 1.5 lakhs, I guess. So
Lovely. So that's pretty affordable, my most students.
Yes.
Okay. And as I can judge, I can sense that you all had a very good experience at CDS. But if you could just briefly tell us, how was college life there for those 2 years that you were there?
So for me, I mean, like the college life is pretty interesting there. I mean, it's kind of both things. But for me, it was pretty good because the campus is very beautiful. So first of all, and like in terms of, because the batch size was very small, so for us, one of the good things is there is no, I mean, you are friends with everyone. So now whenever you go somewhere or whatever is happening, so I mean, you everyone goes together. So the batch unity, the feeling of batch unity was very, very strong there among all of us. Apart from that, if I talk about like the professors living in the campus, so that was a good thing, because we could like knock some of the professor's doors at around 2 a.m. to ask any of our doubts. So this was really helpful for me when I was doing my dissertation, because like even some of our professors, so I mean the younger professors, so they don't mind doing this. So we used to sit at their houses for long hours and like do our research projects and kind of get it done. So that was really helpful. apart from that, the other benefit that I see is that we had in our campus was our library. So if you'll see, so our library is like the largest South social science library in South India, and it's the second largest library in India. So it had like almost 11 floors.
Wow.
So that provided you a very good resource, and like the kind of journals that the institute subscribed to. So it was really helpful for all of us. Like so the staying in campus kind of provided us the access to all of those things. And then, I mean, yeah, obviously you had your fun outings and you visited a lot of places. So there were some issues with the food outside, but yeah, I think overall the experience was very good, I would say.
I'm sure. And Kerala is a beautiful state. If you got opportunity to even see around, that would be lovely.
Yeah.
So Kuldeep, could you answer that? How was the course structure? Like, is it applied economics? So what about students who are kind of fearful of maths? How would you, you know, answer this, rate the place for them?
For students who find maths a little overwhelming, how will the course look like for them, right?
Yeah.
I'll talk about what are the pros of CDS and try to answer your question in that. So what I feel the one of the biggest pros of CDS is the fact that the kind of environment that you get there. So when I was doing my master's, I was a bit confused on whether the research is aligned for me or not. Whether I should go into the corporate sector, go back to the corporate sector, because after my graduation, I was working for a while, around 16 months, and then I came back to do my master's in economics and I started giving my interests. Right? So for me, I was in this space where I was not sure whether I wanted to go back to the corporate world or explore the research world or not. So that is why a CDS became an option for me, because what I found was it's one of the best institutes. If you want to have that research pedigree and you want to, you know, pursue your MPhil or a PhD, it's considered to be pretty good in terms of the faculty and everything that was there. So that is the space that I was coming from. In terms of the facilities, the pros are, and as we mentioned, right, we have an excellent library of around 11 floors, state of the art. You get your professors. So most of the professors are living on campus. So the relation that you develop with them, it's pretty good and it stays with you for a while, right? So besides that, but in terms of the course structure, what I felt when I was there in 2 years, it is rigorous. It's quite rigorous in that sense. The maths is also there. It's not as heavy as I would say a DSE or an ISI, or for that matter, IGIDR as well. In terms of the maths, I'm talking about. So here, since it's an applied economics degree, so it's not just about, you know, understanding the theory, sums for that matter as well when you are doing any subject. It was also the angle of research, the angle of what next you can do in a particular subject, whichever subject you pick in CDS. The course structure is such that, as you said, a term paper for each of the subject. Right, and how it is taught as well. So it gives you an angle of how it is applied in the real world. And that is what the inherent course structure is throughout all subjects, actually. So what you tend to do is you tend to see the data, you want to understand how it has impacted historically. You will be reading a lot of papers, a lot of journals, and so that you are able to understand about any topic, any subject that is spoken. So it is rigorous, but it is very application rigorous in that sense. It's not that it's mathematics centric or it is too theoretical. It is a mix of both. And as Preet mentioned, right, the thesis that we do, that is where, you know, all the grind comes. For me personally, that was the where all your grind for the entire 1.5 years comes into picture, where you have to give an original idea. Work one-to-one, and again, as the personal attention comes, really at the aspect of the student ratio is really seen during this time. And you are working one-to-one with a professor who's so knowledgeable in that sense, yeah, and he guides you so that you're able to pull off, because a proper session happens during the end of your project as well, where there is a proper faculty meet that you present your case to. And they counter, so there is a, so basically there's a counter question as well on your research. You are then only you're given the grade accordingly. So it's very similar to an MPhil defense or a PhD defense that you'll be doing once you get into that aspect of your education as well. So it gives you the entire flavor company.
Right. Lovely. So that it seems like a lovely place to be at.
Yep.
So Preet, could you answer us the very pressing questions the students have? It seems like PhD, you're pretty sorted. You are doing your dissertation, you're writing term papers. It has great faculty. So it seems like PhD placements would be really, really good. So could you just, you know, corroborate that about PhDs? If you want to do a PhD in abroad, then, you know, how, what support from CDS could you expect from that? And then answer the question about corporate placements that, you know, how are they and how would you, how would a student who is solely focused on placements, what can he expect out of CDS?
Sure. So I'll first start with the PhD. So now given the research pedigree that we get, so most of the students who kind of come to research, so I would say out of the batch split, if I have to split the batch of mine, so out of 20 people, almost around 12 to 14 people wanted to pursue their higher studies abroad. So may it be like a second master's abroad, they wanted to specialize more on development economics, so they wanted to do PhD. So now talking about some of the people, I mean, so in terms of, so people did apply a lot, and I think some of our students are already studying, they did their MPhil at Oxford, some of the students did their MPhil at Duke University in US. So that, and I think one of my friend was also in one of the university at Switzerland. So I don't, I think it's a graduate Institute of Development Studies. So some of the students are there, but some of the students they wanted to pursue, let's say research in some of the research wings like NCAER, or maybe they want to do their internships at RBI, which should kind of provide them an exposure, and then they want to go abroad to do their higher studies. So CDS kind of gives you the opportunity for everything. So now given that most of our professors are PhD themselves from abroad, or they have done their postdocs abroad, and they have collaborations in their research work with professors as well who are working abroad. So that kind of provides a very good reference point from the professor's perspective. And that really helps a student, because when this professor's kind of write a letter of recommendation for them, so it really matters. So yes, that is one of the things that you could definitely expect from students. And the second thing is like being there and being in the shoes when you are working on your thesis. So now one of the things that you have is direction, that okay, so once you have decided something post experiencing that, you are sure that this is something that you're going to pursue. So that is another advantage that CDS would provide to someone who has decided on doing a PhD, because he knows how the life is going to be. So this is the second advantage that I would say someone would have while doing a PhD or while applying for a PhD abroad. And in terms of like other aspects, if I'll say in terms of support, I mean around that for GRE and other stuff. So there are a lot of books in the library which students can always refer to along with, I mean, apart from the coaching institutes which are there around. So I think you kind of get access to everything once you want to go abroad and you have made up your mind. And I think some of the professors, they also help you in understanding how to write your, let's say, SOP and all those things. So they kind of also help you in that. So that's a good advantage. So one of the major advantages that I have seen is while doing a PhD abroad or applying for your PhD abroad, if you have a publication, or if you have like a publication, that really helps. So now some of the students who have really put a lot of effort into their dissertation and what they do is they kind of spend extra 3 to 4 months and they try to get their work published. And a lot of students have their works published, so which really helps them in applying for PhD abroad. So I think these are some ways that I would say CDS kind of prepares you for research work abroad and like how it helps you. So now coming to corporate placements, I mean, so I would say JNU, right? So JNU very recently did not allow corporate to come into the campus, and it did not. So now CDS kind of follows the same philosophy, because it's a wing of JNU. So even we did not have, or we were not allowed to call corporates into our campus very recently. So in fact ours was the first batch where we actually invited companies to our campus. So prior to that you could apply on your own, teachers would help you as well, but then the companies are not allowed to come to the institute. So now for our batch, it was the first time that we kind of called a few companies. So that included, like, let's say corporates, but if some of the students want to get into some kind of, let's say teaching profession, not exactly teaching profession, but let's say in some sort of foundations like Azim Premji Foundation or JPAL and all those things. So we also had a conversation with them, and Azim Premji Foundation also visited the campus. So we had around 3-4 companies like EY, Deloitte and all those things visiting our campuses. And now given our batch size is very small, which is 20, so it kind of, I mean, it does not show well when you want to apply for corporate, because I mean, like, given the location disadvantage that you might have a little. So that is most of the things that we kind of resort to is like alumni base. So let's say for us, like Kuldeep was there at Nielsen. So I mean, and so that's how we kind of bring companies to our campus, mostly through alumni. And because the batch size is very small, it's not a hindrance, that because hardly, I think 7 to 8 people or 50% of the batch wants to get placed. So it's easily done that way. Okay. So I would say, so for research, it's a very good place, but for corporate placements, I mean, you need to get the support from your alumni, and you need to be more proactive in terms of getting corporate placements, I would say. So, okay.
But since the numbers are small, I'm sure something would be, they would manage something. They would, doesn't seem like it's going to be that, you know, we students are going to be left in the lurch that,
Definitely not. Because if you look at it from our batch, so almost all the people who wanted to get into corporates, they got into corporates. So even I think the same would be the case with Kuldeep's batch. So it's not like people don't get into it. It's just that you have to put a bit more effort as you would while you want to do a PhD, is what I would say. Yeah.
Because it's not a system yet, so a little more effort needs to be put in.
Yes, I mean, and every year we are kind of growing because. So I think like last year, the number of students like getting into it, getting into corporates and having that kind of exposure is increasing. So every year it keeps on increasing because the alumni, like the number of students into corporate fields kind of grows, and the reach grows. So that would really help. Yeah.
Okay. And also if you could just help us in understanding that what was the kind of where if you invited companies, from where did the companies come? What was the location? You know, where are the students placed? And what are the kind of average packages that you saw in your time? So everyone, this is 2007. You passed out in 2017. So these are 2017 figures. But it'll give us some idea about, you know, what location and packages to expect.
Sure. So I'll just talk about corporate things. So if I have to talk about the locations, right? So most of the, like Nielsen is based out of Bangalore, and the other job, the other companies that we had, they were kind of based either out of Hyderabad or Delhi. So one of the company was based out of Trivandrum as well, but the brand was very good. So it was one of the big fours. So that's true. Okay. That was fine. So I mean, once you get into the company, you could definitely apply for a relocation or that sort of thing after a year. Okay. So, and in terms of package, if I'll say, the in terms of economics, I think the overall, for our batch, the average was somewhere around 9.5.
That's excellent.
Yeah. So I mean, because the number of students are also very less, and the positions that we kind of apply to is into good stuff, and we know the alumni, so that kind of really helps. So I think this was the average, I would say, for all the people who get into corporates.
Okay, that's actually very good to hear, and I'm if it's a good salary, then I'm sure the profiles would also be good in terms of the kind of jobs that you are expected to do.
Yes, for Nielsen, I would say the job that we had, so it was more into data analytics, and it was very rigorous stuff, and it would really help you into the career, because I mean, if you see the analytics is the hot market right now.
Yes.
So apart from that, for people who are interested kind of getting into finance, we also had companies who were into a risk analyst profile and those sort of a thing. So yeah, so some of the students got into that in some of the big fours, and then they got into, let's say then they pursued their FRM, CFA, and then they're in good positions in those companies right now. So that's the overall idea, I think. Yeah. And some of the students, they got into research, economic research wing of some of the institutes like PwC and all those things. So yeah.
Okay. Kuldeep, what was the average packages in your time? This is 2013. So we'll know of the growth that happened,
I passed out. So my batch passed out around 2015. Right?
Yeah.
So during that time, the average, in my batch, only few people actually opted for corporate placements. I guess it was just 3 or 4 of us.
Okay.
And the average package was around 8.
Okay. So it's been growing steadily. So we would expect that now in 2020-21, it would have perhaps grown from the 9.5 figure that was there in Preet's time also.
Yes.
All right, lovely. So I think we've covered, from my side, I've asked you a lot of questions and hopefully covered all the things that students had their mind. If there's anything else that you would like to add, both of y'all, in the end, we would love to hear your words.
Okay, I'll go first on this. So Preet actually has done a fabulous job. He has covered all the experiences that I could think of as well. a few positives from my side. I'll also try to give you a flavor of what are the pros that I saw and what are the cons, perhaps, if I can list that as well. So the pros will be the fact that besides everything that Preet mentioned, there's also the opportunity of working, doing your internship after the end of the first year as well. The opportunities that you get in CDS. So like for me, I did my internship with the Kerala Planning Commission. And the Kerala Planning, at least till my batch, and I think so it was there with Preet's batch as well, and the subsequent batches. We have the Kerala Planning Commission coming to campus to pick up students for their internship program. And that's a two-month thing that happens. And actually, I was fortunate enough that the paper that I was doing in the Kerala Planning Commission, I had sent that to the Delhi Planning Commission as well, and my internship got extended there as well. So I worked around 1.5 months for the Kerala Planning Commission, and then around a month with the Delhi Planning Commission as well. So
that's lovely.
So besides all what Preet mentioned, right, the research aspect, the corporate aspect, this internship, you also get the opportunity for the RBI internship as well. Right, the Reserve Bank of India internship. A lot of students, three students from my batch, did their internship with RBI as well. So as I said, right. Of course, it comes down to the student as well. That how driven are you regarding what you want to do in your life?
Yes.
See, that comes, I guess, with any college, any institute, or any field that you go. Right.
Absolutely.
So that drive has to come from within a little. And as Preet mentioned, in terms of corporates, since our batch size is low and we have so many alumni across for so many years, so it was a little bit tougher for us. But now, I guess, with so many alumni spread across so many things, you have a lot of options to choose from. So regular corporates are, of course, there. You have Citibank, Nielsen, and where we are as well. So the network is pretty strong in that sense. Since the batches were low. So be rest assured in that sense that getting opportunities to get placed, I think so you will get plenty, as in based on the network that you have. But besides that as well, even if you want to pursue your research, so a lot of people actually go for people who are doing working as research assistants in IIM Ahmedabad, in IFMR, people who are working in Delhi as well. So all these research institutes also pay a very good, JPAL. So all these people, they pay handsomely. It's an amazing exposure, especially if you want to go into the research field more, right? The development field more. So all these avenues are also there. Besides your regular either MPhil, PhD or a corporate job, these avenues also open up great. And it's something for that student to explore actually what works for him. What you think he can give it a shot and what he likes doing as well. So in terms of that, the avenues are plenty and you can choose from what works for you. That is what I think.
Okay, that's really nice to hear actually. I'm actually getting excited at hearing all the things that you're talking about. So I think it's so nice that we've had this opportunity for you and Preet to come and explain so many things. Even I was not aware, even being here so long, so many things about CDS that I didn't know. So it is, thank you so much for this, Kuldeep. I'm sure I found it very useful and a lot of students will find it very useful. So Preet, thank you so much to you also. Thank you both for your time. Kuldeep, it was great talking to you again after such a long time.
Yes. And thank you, ma'am. Pleasure always.
Thank you, Preet, for coming with Kuldeep, agreeing to do this. It was really helpful. I can tell this from the students who are going to hear this interview, that it's going to really help clear up their minds and help them take a decision. So thank you both so much for that and for giving your time to this.
Thank you. thanks a lot.